Is daar enige van julle wat gaga wil hallo sê voor ons begin? Is there anybody that would hello before we start?
Hello, ma'am.
Hello, Gavin.
I'm not ready.
Sorry.
Yeah.
You're not?
Ready.
First moment.
Thank you. Okay. Is there nog iemand wat gaga wil hallo sê that quickly wants to say hello before we start?
Hello, ma'am.
Hallo, Fancy. Hoe gaan dit?
Fine.
Yes.
Goeiemôre, juffrou. Hoe gaan dit?
Goed met jou, Klee.
Ek is goed.
Mooi.
Hi ma'am, hoe gaan dat?
Goed met jou, Gabriel.
Goed.
Dat is mooi. Goed, gauw laatste keer. Is daar iemand wat graag wil hallo sê voor ons begin? Is there anybody that would like to say hello to us before we start? Okay.
Hallo ma'am.
Hallo mekaar, hoe gaan dit?
Hallo ma'am.
Gaan goed met my, dankie Mikaela.
Hallo ma'am.
Hi ma'am.
Hi ma'am.
Hallo, hoe gaat het met jou?
Goed, dankie.
Dat is mooi. Amal welkom, amal welkom, welcome everybody. Dit is baie lekker om julle amal weer te sien. Dit is oud vir oggend, so ek is blij om te sien dat amal hier is en reg is om te werk. Goed, ek het nog nie van julle se poste, plakate gekry vir jou post of permits. Julle Julle plakate, Philippe. So ek vraag my, send me your posters, please send me your pamphlets. I'm going to put down my email address in the chat box, just for in case any of you have it. So, please, guys, send me your posters. Okay. Goed, kom ons spring sommer dadelik in. Môre julle almal wat chat. Morning everybody that's saying hello on the chat. I'm happy to see you guys. Good. Kom ons doen gaga 'n bietjie hersiening. Let's clear it all words. Asai. Ons het 'n sinoniem. Twee woorde, dezelfde betekenis. A synonym, two words, they, two different words, they mean. So, van julle wat vandag gaga vir my in die wil antwoord of in die chatbox antwoord, moet ek aan jou.
Ma'am, what's up? That's going.
Sorry?
Ma'am, the buzz sound is not here, but there is something else than the buzz sound.
Like what sound?
Like something like an alarm.
I don't think it's on my side because nothing going on my side.
Okay.
Thank you. Sorry, my internet connection is fine this morning and my headset, I think, is fine. And it's quiet, so I don't know. Maybe you should just check your connection, please.
Okay.
Thank you, Mintley. Good. Is there anyone who vandaag for my a voorbeeld will give met a synonym? Is there anybody who wants to give me a synonym? Okay, Zoe, I come with you. Yes, Zoe.
Play and gelach.
Thank you, Zoe. Good. Gabriel, I come with you.
Yes. Hi, ma'am.
Hello.
Mooi en prachtig.
Baie mooi, dankie.
Gesagus.
Dankie. Goed, ek is voordat ons aangaan, wil ek het vir julle sê, onthou, hierdie werk wat ons elke dag doe, the work that we do every day, this will be the type of questions. We are still at the synonyms, but we can start with the antonyms.
Vet en meer.
Baie mooi, vet en maar. It's fat and skinny. Baie mooi, dankie Michaela.
Welcome, man.
Good. Guys, okay, kom ons gaan aan na die antonieme toe. Soos Michaela nou vir ons gesê het. Een antoniem is twee woorde met die twee teenoorgestelde betekenis. An antonym is two words with the opposite meaning. It's two words of the opposite meaning. Michaela, ek unmute jou.
Oom en lach.
Zeg haar weer.
Huil en lach.
Huil en lach. Baie mooi.
You're welcome, man.
Bless you. Meneer, I'm going to unmute you.
Synonyme en antonyme.
Mooi, synonyme en antonyme. Oulik, dankie. Goed, Zoe, ek unmute jou.
Homofone en homofoon.
Okay. Not quite, because it's not the opposite. But I appreciate you for trying. Wil jy ander enetjie probeer, Zoe?
Meer en vet.
Baie oulik, maar en vet. Dankie, Zoe.
Yes, welkom.
Goed, Michaela.
en af.
Oulik, op en af. Dankie, Makayla.
Welkom, man.
Een vriend sê, ek kan mute jou.
Huil en lag.
Huil en lag. Baie mooi. Dankie, Oefense.
Welkom.
Makayla, ek unmute jou. Yes.
Kleen en groet.
Sê weer.
Kleen en groet.
Excuse, ek het nie gehoor nie.
Klein en groot.
Klein en groot. Baie oulik. Dankie, Makayla. Goed. Voor Taryn, het ek gaan kyk na die betekenis van teenoorgesteldes. Taryn asked about the opposites yesterday. Taryn, the definition of opposites that I could find for you is... The opposites are pairs of words that have different meanings. Dis die beste beskrywing van opposites wat ek vir jou kon kry, my kind. It's pairs of words that has different meanings. For example, big, little, fast, slow, happy, sad. Good. Makayla, ek gaan jou unmute. Yes. Koud en warm. Baie oulik, dankie.
Welkom, man.
Ok, dan gaan ons aanbeweeg na die volgende een toe. Ons volgende woord is 'n voegwoord. A conjunction. A conjunction heg twee sinne aan mekaar. A conjunction... Put two separate sentences together to make it one long sentence. For example, Sari hou van dans en Emma hou van lees. Goed. Is there anybody that would like to make a sentence with a conjunction for me? You are more than welcome to type it in the chat or raise your hand. Jy is welkom om dit in die kletsbox vir ons te skryf, of jy kan jou hand vir ons lig, dan sal ek jou unmute. Makayla, ek kan mute jou. Goed, wil jy vir ons 'n woord maak met 'n voegwoord, 'n gesin maak met 'n voegwoord? Would you like to make us a sentence with a conjunction in? Ok. Goed, meneenkle, ek kan mute jou.
Ek eet my kos, want ek is honger.
Baie mooi, dankie meneenkle.
More than welcome.
Goed, nou wil ek hê julle moet vir my na die sin luister. Dan moet julle vir my antwoord wat die voegwoord in daai sin was. Ek hou van lees en my sissie hou van speel. Wat was die voegwoord in my sin? What was the conjunction in my sentence? Quickly type it in the chat box for me. Ek hou van lees en my sissie hou van speel. Quickly type the conjunction for me, please. Meneenkle, ek kan mute jou.
No, ma'am. I thought that we could raise our hands.
You can always raise your hand in my class. You are always welcome to answer, Meneenkle. If you'd like to answer, you are more than welcome.
The answer is N.
Baie mooi. N. Baie mooi. I see everybody answered me. Thank you so much for everybody that answered. Okay. Luister nou my volgende sin. Quickly listen to my next sentence. Ek is bang, want ek hoor iets. Ek is bang, want ek hoor iets. Mooi, Michaela. Skryf gaga vir my die vigwoord neer in ons chat sommer. Zoe, ek kan mute jou. Yes, Zoe.
Die vigwoord is want.
Prachtig, dankie Zoe.
Is welkom.
Oulik, dankie vir almal se antwoorde in die chatbox. As ons, okay, wacht, Michaela, ek kan mute jou gou. Yes, Michaela.
Mam is the want.
Baie mooi, dankie Michaela.
Welcome, ma'am.
Goed. If I do something like this in an assessment, as ek so iets in a assessering doen, sal ek vir jou 'n sin gee en vir jou vra, watter woord is die voegwoord? If we do this in a assessment, I will ask you guys, look at the sentence and quickly write down the conjunction for me. Goed. Ons volgende woord waarmee ons gaan aanbeweeg is gaga 'n werkwoord. Can anybody please quickly give me a verb? Is daar iemand wat gaga vir my werkwoord kan gee? 'N Werkwoord is iets wat ons doen. It's something that we are doing. As ek vir julle in 'n assessering hierdie wil vra, dan gaan ek vir julle sê: die dogtertjie verf 'n prentjie. En dan gaan ek vir julle vra, haal vir my die werkwoord uit. If we do this in assessments, I can give you a sentence and ask you, which word in this sentence is the verb? That is the way I would ask this in a assessment. Goed. 'N Werkwoord is iets wat ons doen. In ons chat, sal julle asseblief gaga vir my elkeen 'n sin maak met 'n werkwoord? Can everybody quickly type a sentence with a verb in, please? Ek unmute jou. Yes.
Ek steel. Ek steel.
Ek speel.
Speel in die huis.
Mooi. Ek speel in die huis. Watter woord in jou sin is jou werkwoord? Which word is the verb in your sentence?
Speel.
Baie mooi. Dankie. Goed, Zoe, ek kan mute jou.
Ek skryf op die papier vir skool.
Mooi. En watter woord sal jou werkwoord wees daar?
Skryf.
Baie mooi. Dankie, Zoe.
Jy is welkom.
Goed. Michaela het in ons klets vir ons gesê en ons chat, ek skoon my huis. Michaela, dis mooi. Al wat ek anders sou doen is, ek maak my huis skoon. Dan is skoon maak jou werkwoord. Maar dankie dat jy vir my getik het, jong. OK, Michaela, ek kan mute jou. Yes, Michaela.
Man, ek speel want my friends.
Ek speel met my maats. Baie mooi, Michaela. Michaela, watter woord in ek speel saam met my maats is 'n werkwoord? Which one of those words is the verb?
Mam, it's speel.
Well, mooi, dankie, Makayla.
You're welcome, man.
Okay, Sia Bonga, ek gaan jou unmute.
Ek hallo. Weet hoe mis.
Zeg maar weer.
Nee.
Yes, Sia Bonga. Ek eet roomijs. Baie mooi. Kan jy vir ons sê wat is die werkwoord daar?
Eet.
Baie mooi. Dankie, Sia Bonga. Oké, okay, mijn Ninkle, ik ga jou unmute.
Ma'am, I wanted to ask a question.
Yes?
You have a sentence and you have to write she twice. Because I have a sentence because I'm writing down a sentence, but then I don't really know if you can. So it says, I'm trying to say that she loves the rain, but it is too cold.
Okay.
So, but then she will catch a cold, right? But
yeah.
Then how can you say, because if you write say in the middle of the sentence, you'll be talking about a boy. So, can you actually write say in the middle of a sentence? Because I cannot write her.
Quickly type the sentence for me so I just make sure I understand you correctly.
Okay.
Meneer, did you write the sentence for me?
Yes, ma'am, I'm almost done.
Okay, it's fine.
Okay. Just stick my carry on. I'll type it in.
Okay. Okay, guys. Asai, good. Oké, kom ons beweeg gou aan, dan wag ek vir hom. Unati, ek wil sê dankie vir jou plakkaat. I have received your poster. Thank you so much. Goed, ons volgende woord is 'n selfstandige naamwoord. It's something that you can see and that you can touch. I'm just quickly going over this one because we need to move on. Okay. 'N selfstandige naamwoord is iets wat jy kan eet en kan voel. Ag, ekskuus, iets wat jy kan voel en wat jy kan sien. It's something that you can touch and you can see. Byvoorbeeld, die seun lees 'n boek, dan is dit seun en boek. Goed. Ons het gister geleer van homonieme. Ons nuwe woord was homonieme. The new word was homonieme. Dit word die homonieme word dieselfde gespel en het klink dieselfde, maar die betekenis verskil. It's spelled the same and sounds the same, but the meaning is different. Oomofoon word nie dieselfde gespel nie, en hy word en hy nie dieselfde betekenis nie, maar hy klink dieselfde. Okay, goed. Ek wil net gou vir my enkele antwoord. Ek sien uit my geskryf, she loves the rain, but she will catch a cold. In Afrikaans kan jy sê, sy hou van die reën, maar sy gaan siek word. So you are allowed to say sy again.
Okay then, thank you.
Thank you, Maninkle. Okay, goed. Ons gaan gaga aan beweeg, anders gaan ons nie klaar kry met al ons werk nie, dan gaan die tyd ons vang. Goed, die homofone, sounds the same. But the meanings, but the meaning and spelling is different. Homonyme. Homonyme is spelled the same and it sounds the same, but the meaning is also different. Goed, Michaela, ek unmute jou. Yes, Michaela.
And for the homonyme, it's licht en lig.
Lig en lig. Baie mooi. Ek sien jy het om in die chat ook vir ons gesê. Dis oulik. Dankie, Michaela. Goed. Okay. Guys, now I'm going to ask you. Quickly in the chat box. Everybody in the chat box. Give me an example of a homofoon. Hy is nie dieselfde gespel nie, it's not spelled the same. It does not have the same meaning, but it sounds the same. Everybody in the chat box, quickly give me an example of a homophone, please. Sometimes sometimes you get confused with homoniem en homophone. Partykeer raak die kinders die mekaar met homonieme en homofone. Omdat die woorde dieselfde klink, onthou, a homofoon word nie dieselfde geskryf nie. It's not spelled the same and it does not have the same meaning, but it sounds the same. Zoe, ek unmute jou.
Maar en maar.
Maar en maar. Baie mooi. Dankie, Zoe.
Jy is welkom.
Okay, Michaela, ek unmute jou.
Men val en val.
Val en val. Baie oulik. Dankie, Michaela.
Welkom, man.
Okay. Meninkle, ek unmute jou.
Dokter en dokter.
Dokter en dokter. Baie oulik. Dankie, Meninkle.
You're mostly welcome.
Goed, so, okay, nou vraag ek die volgende vraag is, gee vir my vinnig een voorbeeld van een homoniem. Quickly give me an example van een homoniem. Hy is dieselfde, it's spelled the same, it sounds the same, but the meanings are different. Hy is dieselfde gespel, hy klink dieselfde, maar die betekenisse is anders. So, wil julle vir my vinnig dit in die kletsbox, in die chatbox, gaga vir my kan stuur asseblief. Michaela, ek unmute jou.
Yes. It's race en race.
Baie mooi, race en race. Dankie, Michaela. Okay, ons gaan vinnig aanbeweeg. Goed, ons volgende woorde waarna ek wil kyk. The next words I want to put want to bring into wat ek vir julle wil excuse. Die volgende woorde waaraan ons wil werk. Michaela, ek unmute jou. Yes.
Mama, I read the sentences.
Let me quickly explain to you guys, then we can go read the examples.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Michaela. guys, it's very nice that all of you are participating. Boy, dankie dat julle almal so mooi antwoord. Okay. Goed, ons eerst volgende woord wat ek graag wil van waaroor ek wil praat is 'n byvoeglike naamwoord. 'N byvoeglike naamwoord is in Engels an adjective. 'N byvoeglike naamwoord in English is an adjective. Dit vertel jou meer oor die selfstandige naamwoord. It tells you more about the noun. Goed. As jy sê die dogtertjie dra 'n rok, dan is dogtertjie 'n selfstandige naamwoord en 'n rok is 'n selfstandige naamwoord. Nou dit beskryf vir jou, dit vertel jou wat, hoe is die selfstandige naamwoord. So, dan gaan dit wees die mooi dogtertjie dra 'n pink rok. Goed. When we do an adjective, it describes the noun. It tells you something a little bit more about the noun. If I'm telling you the girl is wearing a dress, the girl is going to be an adjective, it's going to be a noun, and the dress is going to be a noun. So I'm asking you, what about the noun? How does the noun look? Tell me more about the noun. Then I'm going to use an adjective to describe the noun. Then I'm going to tell you, the pretty girl is wearing a pink dress. So, as jy daai sinnetjie kry, if you get that sentence, mooi en pink. Pretty and pink is going to be the adjective. Is daar enige van julle wat gou vir my 'n voorbeeld wil gee van 'n byvoeglike naamwoord of an adjective? Sorry, ek kan mute jou. Yes.
Ek speel met die rooi en groen bal.
Baie mooi. So rooi en groen beskryf die bal, dan is dit 'n byvoeglike naamwoord. Oulik. Dankie.
Jy is welkom.
Goed. Is daar nog iemand wat vinnig vir my 'n sin wil maak met 'n byvoeglike naamwoord? Okay, Zoe, ek kan mute jou.
Ek waar 'n blou en grys uniform.
Baie mooi. Ek dra 'n blou en grys uniform. Oulik. Dan gaan blou en grys ons byvoeglike naamwoord wees. Dankie, Zoe.
Jy is welkom.
Goed. Ons volgende woord waarna ons gou-gou gaan aanbeweeg is 'n bywoord. 'N bywoord in Engels is 'n adverb. 'N bywoord vertel jou meer van 'n werkwoord. So 'n byvoeglike naamwoord vertel jou van die selfstandige naamwoord en 'n bywoord vertel jou van die werkwoord. Both these words are used to describe something. Albei hierdie woorde is gebruik om 'n idee of 'n gedagte te beskryf. Goed. So a byword is an adverb and it's used to describe the verb. As jy 'n werkwoord het, dan sê jy wat jy doen. Ek loop. Hoe loop ek? Ek loop vinnig. Dan gaan vinnig jou byword wees. If you are saying I am walking. How am I walking? I'm walking fast. Then fast is going to be your adverb. Okay. Baie mooi. Is daar enige van julle wat vinnig vir my 'n voorbeeld wil gee? Zoe, ek unmute jou. Yes.
Ek is in 'n vinnig helikopter.
Okay, dit wat jy vir ons beskryf het, Zoe, is 'n byvoeglike naamwoord. I'm going to explain to you why. As jy helikopter is 'n selfstandige naamwoord because helicopter was a noun, You describe the noun, then it becomes an adjective. Baie mooi. Can you quickly give me a sentence of an adverb? You need to use a verb to be able to use an adverb. Can you quickly give me a sentence with that, Zoe? Jy is gelukkige oulike kind. Yes, you are very smart. I know you can do it.
My hond. My hond. My hond loop vinnig.
Baie mooi. My hond loop vinnig. Hy loop, hoe loop hy? Hy loop vinnig. So vinnig is ons bywoord. Dankie Zoe.
Jy is welkom.
Goed. Meneer Klee, ek gaan jou unmute.
Ma'am, I just have a quick question.
Yes.
Ma'am, in English, in adverbs, don't the adverbs have an ly? But then in Afrikaans, what do they end with?
An adverb doesn't necessarily end on something. It describes the verb. Uh-huh. So if you have a verb saying walking, then you must ask yourself, how am I walking or how is he walking? If you say he is walking fast, he describes the verb. So now, you know, he's walking fast. So the adverb is going to be fast. It's describing the verb.
Yes, ma'am.
So the descriptive word in the sentence is the adverb.
Okay.
Am I explaining? Do you understand that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So,
yes.
So, even if in English you're having an adverb, you don't always have to end with ly.
Not in Afrikaans, no.
Oh.
In Afrikaans, it's describing the verb. It's the descriptive word of the verb.
So, ma'am, I'm not sure if I'm going to learn this at school, but...
Mm-hmm.
So, but at school they taught me that, but then at school they never taught me about these. But then at school it says that all the adverbs have to end with ly. Well, most.
Okay, can I make a note on that, Meninkle? And then I'm going to ask someone else just to make sure I'm explaining it correctly to you guys. Because I'm also human, I can also make a mistake. So, is it fine if I make a note and come back to you on that? Just to make sure.
Yes.
Okay. I'm quickly going to make a note. On Monday, we are going to talk to this again. I'm going to ask the English home language teacher. What is her input on that?
Okay.
Thank you, Maninkle.
You're mostly welcome.
Okay. Good. Is there any more questions, guys? Is there anybody else that would like to quickly give me an example? Hi, hardloop stadig. Oulik, siyabonga. I am eating ice cream very slow. Mooi, Malik. Malik, that is 100%. But in Afrikaans is it, ek eet roomys stadig. But the concept is 100%. Thank you. Okay. Meninkle, I'm going to unmute you. Meninkle?
Ma'am?
Yes.
No, that is the only question that I wanted to know.
Your hand is still up. I'm quickly lowering it. Thank you, Meninkle.
Thank you.
Zoe, I can mute you.
Mijn ma kook kos.
Okay, my ma kook kos. Oulik. So the verb, the werkwoord in daai sin gaan wees kook. Hoe kook sy kos, Zoe? How is she cooking?
My ma kook die kos stadig.
Mooi. Sy kook haar kos stadig. Baie dankie, Zoe.
Jy is welkom.
Goed, Siabonga. Hy eet baie vinnig aandete. Baie oulik, so die vinnig gaan die bywoord wees. Goed. Okay, guys, we have a few minutes left. Are there one or two of you that quickly would like to read to us? Is daar een of twee van julle wat graag vir ons vinnig wil lees? Ek het seker gemaak, ons tekste is groot genoeg. I made sure everything is big enough today. Zoe, ek unmute jou.
Hompie kompie. Hompie kompie. Hompie kompie sit op die wal. Hompie kompie het die afval. Die koningse soldaat probeer al wat hulle kan. Maar hompie kompie bly pad soos a pan.
Dankie, Zoe. Okay, Michaela, ek unmute jou.
Lees ons, lees saam. Die bay, die see. Die krab en die kreef is maats. Hulle woon saam onder die kraan. Krab soek kroek om vir die kreef die glie. Hy vra toe verkrik om hom te help, krik al baie oud en krom. Hy dra en kroon wol kreel met krik en sy help sal heel het maklik kry.
Baie mooi, dankie Michaela.
You're welcome, ma'am.
Goed. Bandile, ek gaan jou unmute. Hi.
Hompie gedompie sit op die wal. Hompie gedompie het afgeval. Die koningse soldaat probeer al wat hy kan, maar hompie gedompie bly plat soos 'n pan.
Baie mooi, dankie. Goed, meneer Klee? Okay.
Ma'am, are there also different stories?
No, I only have these ones.
Okay. Kloiwar, Prajais in die hoer. Die gunstas op die hone gras. Die indies op die waterplas. Ek weens dat kan jy groter was om al die drietjes op die bus. Op de bus.
Mooi, dank je, meneer Klee.
Goed.
Oké, ons is nou uit tijd uit. We are out of time. But all of you that would like to read, I'm going to give you a chance again on Monday. Ek wil net vir julle sê dankie vir ons lekker les. Thank you guys for coming every day. Julle is regtig 'n oulike groep kinders en ek geniet julle vreeslik. You guys are very clever and I enjoy your company very, very much. Ek hoop julle het 'n lekker naweek. Ek hoop en julle moet lekker rus. Bye bye julle.
Bye. Tot ziens.